Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Donnelly. We are in the coach's office of the Charlotte Rush following the Premier's very successful weekend over the Richmond Generals. It's Sunday, September 27th, and to review all of the happy totals, we're going to turn to Trevor Jewell, head coach of the Charlotte Rush Premier. And Trevor, your guys are 4-0 right now. What a start to this 2020-21 season. Let's look at last night's game. David Battisti in goal, I thought, was solid. Your defense was solid. You got four goals and the first one from newcomer Charles Merkley. So just talk about the big win last night, 4-0 over Richmond.
Yeah, obviously Bubba's been really strong in net for us since he got here. I think he's a big part of our team, a huge component for us. You know, he's a leader. He does the things necessary. He works every day. He's always striving to get better. So can't say enough about him. And obviously bringing in Charlie, you know, he can skate, he can shoot. He's a heck of a hockey player. So he's a big addition for us, and it's nice to see him get rewarded in his first game and, you know, really start playing, you know, up and down. I mean, he's been off the ice for a little while, so it was good to see him stay in shape and see him back on the ice. But, you know, those are the kind of pickups we need to make to get better and the things we need to do to be successful in the long run. But, you know, overall, happy with our performance last night. I think we got into a little bit of penalty trouble, but at the same time, you know, we did a great job with our PK killing that off and being strong in the defensive zone.
And heading into today, through three games, the Rush were out shooting, scoring their opponents 17-0. That doesn't happen very often at any level of hockey. And today, Trevor, you come up with a 5-2 win over Richmond, so you sweep the Generals. I'm not joking here, but I just want to know, Charles Merkley, is he in one piece today after the game? I mean, comment on that. He was in the mix of everything, and I don't think I ever saw a guy draw more penalties in one game than Charlie Merkley did today for the Rush.
Yeah, I mean, he's a guy, he's a competitor. He went out there and did everything he could to help the team succeed, and they started to target him and do the things that, you know, the other teams will do to good players. So, you know, I thought he was a catalyst in you know, to our success today. You know, he scored the first goal, and there was a heck of a shot. I thought he battled through things. He played like a man. He didn't retaliate, and he kept playing strong. He kept coming at him and kept going out there despite those guys, you know, taking runs at him and doing things they had to do. But he is in one piece, so we're happy to see that. But, you know, he's got a day of rest tomorrow, and then we'll get back after it on Tuesday.
Tripp Clark, I think, picked up right where he did last weekend, had a strong game, did yield a couple of goals. But anyway, I thought a strong performance by him in the D today.
Yeah, I thought he played pretty well. You know, again, one of the first goals, a power play goal for them. I mean, that's tough. I mean, we got to stay out of the box there. So that on outside, that's our fault, you know, as far as skaters and things like that. But can't allow to be, you know, consecutive PKs like that and let them keep firing pucks from the point and expect Tripp to see everything. So I thought he played well. He performed well. And then, you know, again, we got to stay out of the box to help him out some more. And I think our PK did all right. D did well. I think we got to move pucks a little bit better. But at the same time, you know, they helped him out in times of need. So very happy with their play overall throughout the weekend, but still got a lot of work to do. Mm.
Trevor, talk about a couple of guys that are newcomers to the Rush team this year that I think are having an early impact. Palin Brooks had a goal today, and also C.J. Bachman. He's in the middle of things, too.
Yeah, obviously Palin, you know, he's a prolific scorer coming out of where his youth program in Colorado. Mm. Spent some time in the NCDC last year. Played at the premier level before, so, I mean, there's something there. He's got a heck of a shot. He's got a nose for the net. He's got size. He's got speed. He's got a little bit of grit to him as well, so I think he's been a welcome addition to us. I think it's really fun to watch him play. Mm-hmm. You know, it's really fun to watch him shoot the puck as well. Then obviously C.J. Bachman, I mean, I love watching him play. He gets it done, you know, and everything he does, he's always in your face. He never stops. He just keeps going. He's got a motor. Finds a way to put the puck in the net. I mean, it's two weekends in a row now. He's gotten a goal, so very proud of the way he's playing, and I think, you know, the sky's the limit for both of those guys.
We're talking to Trevor Jewell, head coach of the Charlotte Rush Premier, following the Rush sweep of the Richmond Generals here on this Sunday, September 27th, in the Rush coach's office following this weekend of action. Trevor, I'll tell you what, I'm very impressed with, I think right now you're recruiting, you, Ryan Crothers, and Troy Schwab, you're recruiting A-plus right now. You brought a lot of new guys in, and they're all contributing.
Yeah, I mean, obviously it was a long off season. It was a little bit different for us. Didn't get to travel as much as we have in the past. Didn't get to see as much hockey as we have in the past. But, you know, we worked hard, and it was a collective effort by everyone. And I think, you know, it's starting to pay dividends early. But at the end of the day, you know, we never stop working, and we're always still looking. We always want to get better and looking for that next piece of the puzzle. So we're very happy with what we have. But, you know, it's a day-to-day business right now. I mean, guys got to show up and put in the work every day. And, you know, obviously we want to continue to get better because we want to – do exactly what we did last year, mm-hmm. and win the division. You know, we get playoffs at home this year, and then we want to go for a national championship and get these guys committed. So that's our goal, and we got to make sure we take care of that. So, you know, the process never stops, honestly.
Yeah. Well, again, we hope there's no major injuries for the Rush this year, but I do know between Trevor and Troy and Ryan Crothers, if we need some players and there's any lurking in the weeds out there, they'll find them, I guarantee you that. Chatting with Trevor Jewell post-game here on this Sunday afternoon. And Trevor, we turn our attention to next weekend, our first road contest in the regular season, going to our favorite place, Hampton Roads, to take on another big rivalry weekend against the Whalers. Preview that one for us as we played four games so far in this early 2020-21 season.
Yeah, obviously. I mean, for the next few weeks here, we run through the gauntlet, in my opinion. But I think that's good for us in the long run. We get to see a lot of tough competition early, and I think it's mm-hmm. It's healthy for our guys to see, you know, that how tough our division actually is for the guys that haven't been here, and the guys that have been here. It's good for them to see, you know, these teams that have changed and kind of reloaded and things like that. Mm-hmm. So it's tough, but at the end of the day, you know, obviously excited to go up there and get on the road and get our first road games under our belt. But at the same time, you know, Hampton's a big rival. I think it's the biggest rival we have. It's been, you know, them and us, you know, pretty much going at it for the past 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
On who's winning the division, who's playing in the national championship, and who's got, you know, the top of the line program. You know, so it's something we take to heart. It's something we take personal, and it's obviously a really important rivalry to us. And obviously, it gauges where this division is going to be and where it's going to go throughout the season. And you know, all eyes are on us when we, you know, I guess collide on the weekends. Whenever every time we see them, or whether it's at a showcase or on an everyday weekend here for us, but the excitement's there. It's going to be a nice week of practice. It's going to be a lot of work, a lot of effort, a lot of mm-hmm. attention to detail and things like that. So we're excited, but at the same time, we know it's going to be a challenge.
Mm. All right. Thoughts and observations from Trevor Jewell. The Charlotte Rush 4-0 atop the Southeast Division and have outscored their opponents 22-2 in the first four games. Trevor, great start for you and the Charlotte Rush. We'll look forward to a good series in Hampton Roads. We'll be watching on Hockey TV and wish you guys the best going into Hampton next weekend.
Thanks a lot, Tim.
All right, Trevor Jewell, head coach of the Charlotte Rush Premier. Don't forget, we have lots of videos and information on all of our Charlotte Rush social media platforms, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, our Charlotte Rush YouTube channel, our Charlotte Rush website, and of course, you can also go to the United States Premier Hockey League website for stats, standings, and information. I want to thank Zingo Weidman, our intern from the Carolina School of Broadcasting, for running our camera here today. Thanks so much for watching our premiere wrap-up from a big weekend for the Charlotte Rush. And I'm Tim Donnelly. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.